Hello, my fellow pipers. Horatio here. How's everyone doing, my dear friends? Housekeeping. I'm smoking my Nording that I was smoking yesterday in yesterday's video with the leftovers, and in it, the leftovers of Blue Mountain in 2013. Which yesterday I filled this pipe up and didn't finish it, so I decided to smoke it while I make this video. Okay, my dear friends, I'm doing this video for Pipe Week, my dear friends. Today's Friday. I believe tomorrow's the last day for Pipe Week, my dear friends. And right here, I want to introduce you guys my Dr. Grabo collection. In the first pipe of my Dr. Grabo collection, let me put this pipe down for a second, guys. I'm gonna do this. It's my first briar pipe, which it's a Dr. Grabo, and it's the Riviera. This is the pipe that I mentioned yesterday that I ended up breaking the shank because I did not clean it properly, and within a few years I broke the shank, so I actually just taped it up like a pipe from Citizen Kane, Orson Welles movie. So I dig it still. It's my first briar pipe, but my first pipe was a Corncob Legend, just to clarify. But this was my first briar pipe in 2013. Okay? First Dr. Grabo, guys, in my Dr. Grabo collection. Shortly after that, I went on eBay, because of course I wanted to obtain as many pipes as I want, since I had discovered this wonderful hobby back in the days. So then, I obtained a Dr. Grabo. Bent apple, it's a very classic shape, Meerschaum lined, which I cleaned very thoroughly, and it's a beautiful, beautiful rosticated pipe, with Meerschaum lined. So technically, I guess this was my first Meerschaum, technically. Okay. Next, I have here a Dublin, slightly bent. It's kind of hard to make out. It's definitely Dr. Grabo. I'm not sure if it's a... Oh, it's an Atomatic. And the reason they call these an Atomatic is because, oh, I have one of the filters, Simonelli filters in there. Oh, just a tip, guys, Dr. Grabo's and Corncob pipes, these filters work amazing. Just if you guys didn't know. But yes, this is my Dublin, slightly bent, Dr. Grabo. Then, here's my Viking at the Grabo. Beautiful pipe. It was modeled by the Falcon. And if I'm not mistaken, that the Grabo got sued because of it. I can't reckon what happened. There's information out there. I don't want to gossip. Beautiful pipe, great smoker. It's my Viking Dr. Grabo. Next comes my Dr. Grabo Bulldog. And this bad boy here is a Starfire, my friends. Beautiful, beautiful this occasion. Beautiful bulldog and it's adaptive able. I love this pipe, great smoker. Next comes my Omega. Agreeable, Omega. Beautiful pipe. I believe it's an apple or billiard, but nevertheless, it's an awesome Peterson knockoff. Awesome pipe, great smoker. My Dr. Graber Omega. Then comes my Westbrook Dr. Grebo Poker. And years ago I saw people have obtaining these pipes. Look at it, it still has the patina. That's how old this pipe is. I can't reckon how the year, but great smoker. Beautiful, beautiful bark looking rustication. Like the bark of a tree, look at that. It has the spades in red. Beautiful, beautiful poker. Then comes my freehand Dr. Grebo's. And I have two of them. Beautiful shape. Beautiful freehand. Love the rustication on this one as well. Not too big. Nice size bow. Awesome smokers. Very nice. I love this pipe so much that I went on eBay and got myself another freehand with gouges. No, I'm just kidding. The wormhole rustication. Another nice bowl size. Beautiful pipe. And also great smoker. And my final Dr. Grebo pipe. I introduced to you my last acquisition of the Grebo line. And this pipe here, my dear friends, very special to me. Because this pipe here is a replica of a 1937 Peterson pipe called the John Bull. It was a beautiful, thick Rhodesian English pipe named John Bull. And of course, it was very popular in 1937 when it was released by Peterson. It was so popular that it was popular way to the 40s. And then and on, because in the 1950s, Dr. Grebo made their own version of the John Bull Rhodesian. Thick Rhodesian, beautiful, beautiful pipe. I'm sure they didn't call it. It's from the 1950s because a lot of the, look how old the markings, you can't even see them. They are so worn out. This pipe is from the 1950s. So in the 1950s, they created their own version of the John Bull. It looks like an author pipe. It looks like the 320 from 7LE. But it's a beautiful pipe, great smoker. Nice size bowl. And that's it, my dear friends. This is my Dr. Grebo collection. May you guys have a great, great pipe week. This is Friday. I believe tomorrow is our last day. I want to say thank you to Breyer. The Breyer Report. I just found out. Not just found out. He's the one that came up with Pipe Week. Don't believe what Charlie says. He's a fibber. But my dear friends, God bless you. Have a great Pipe Week. Thank you so much, Phil, from the Breyer Report, for giving us this beautiful holiday, my dear friends. My dear friend. All right. Peace. God bless. And as always, last word for the sponsors. Take care now, guys. Peace.